my good friend Mark Browning at firstplaceparts.com sent me these cool little quick clickers. Now, if you guys aren't familiar with these save you a whole lot of work when you're adjusting your clutch on your skidoos, and they also make your life a lot better, your riding a lot better, because of the ease of adjusting these clutches when you're out playing. Conditions change, we go from trails to powder, cold to hot, all kinds of conditions change, and we're constantly dealing with clutching issues. Some of you guys might be riding nice and cold in the morning, nice fluffy snow, you know, you're getting so many revs out of your machine, and all of a sudden in the afternoon it's really wet and heavy snow, and all of a sudden you're not getting as much power. What's wrong with my sled? Well, you need to do a clutch adjustment, and these are going to help you out. Now, anybody who owns a Skidoo with a TRA clutch, you'll notice when you look at it from the side that there are three adjusting bolts. There are numbers all the way around, and there's a little clocking mark on the bolt itself that you can keep track of where the bolts are set. Now, the bolt is set up like a cam if you look at it. It's not a round bolt shaft all the way through. It's kind of cut out in areas. So as you rotate the bolt, it lifts and lowers the ramp. That's going to give you the fluctuation in your RPMs that you're going to want. So we're going to install these quick clickers. Very easy installation process, and it's only about $50. I mean, this is going to make your riding so much better, and it's very quick to do. You don't really have to take these off your sled to do it. I'll show you what to do. The quick clickers come with the instructions. This clutch is off. You really don't need to take it off your sled to do this, but just for ease of showing you how to do it, I've got one off. You just go around, you use a 10 millimeter wrench, you undo the nut. You don't remove the bolt, because if you remove the bolt, then a bunch of washers are gonna come out inside, then you have to take your clutch apart. So you just leave the bolt where it is. And it'll stay there for you. Got this old school wrench here. Came out of a Land tool kit way back when. Don't need all the fancy tools all the time, right? I've got that nut off. I'm gonna install my quick clicker. I just wanna make sure that that little silver set screw on the inside is flush with the blue clicker itself. You just push it on and give her a few turns, about three turns. It's gonna be a little loose, doesn't seem like you're gonna have enough thread on there, but you will. When you push that out, the bolt head isn't actually gonna come out far enough, you're gonna notice, but that's okay. I'm gonna show you what to do. You just take the set screw, your 13 millimeter wrench, you turn that in because it's gonna tighten up in there and it has red thread locker on it. It's gonna keep it nice and snug. And then you're just gonna push the quick clicker in, and you're gonna turn this bolt with the 13 mil wrench. It's gonna chamfer the edges of this housing a little bit. And it's gonna give you a nice free-flowing bolt. That's perfect. Now when you're using this, you wanna make sure that they're all on the same setting at once. If you have them on position one, you're gonna always want every one of them on one. You don't wanna have them offset because it's gonna throw the balance of your clutch off. Now with these quick clickers, as you increase in number, so if we go from a 3 to a 4, we're generally gonna get about 200 extra RPM per click. So if we're at 7,800 RPM on clicker 3, and we go to clicker 4, we should be around 8,000 RPM. As you go up, you increase your RPM. So it's always good to know that. So check them out at firstplaceparts.com. Tell them Louis from PowerMod sent you, of course. Go put these on your sled. You're gonna notice a difference on those really hot days, especially like today out there. I need extra RPM. I'm gonna get them with these. I gotta thank you guys for watching. Keep coming back.
Make it impossible.